Hello and welcome to Poland. My name is Paweł, and as today it's raining, it's a great chance to go to visit museums. And now I'm in front of the Czartoryski Museum, what is housing the best painting in Poland, Leonardo da Vinci, Lady with an Ermine. And in today's episode, I want to explain you who is on that portrait, what animal does she carry in her hands, and if you will wait until the end of that video, you will find how I became an owner of that great piece of art. Shall we? We are in the main hall of Czartoryski Museum in Kraków, what is the oldest and one of the biggest museums in Poland. The collection was created in Puławy in 1796 by Izabela Czartoryska, princess. Then, in 1878, the museum in Kraków was opened in few buildings in the old town. The museum is divided into few sections and we'll skip most to get to the most important art collection with the Leonardo's painting. Was his name. Da Vinci means from Vinci, the village in Italy, Tuscany, where he was born in 1452. Now he's recognized as the best painter of all time. Mona Lisa is the best recognized portrait, and The Last Supper is the most reproduced religious painting. And the best known painting in Poland is Lady with an Ermine, in Italian Dama l'Ermelino, in Polish Dama z Gronostajem. At the beginning it was known only as a portrait of a lady, but now after many studies we know that it's a portrait of Cecilia Gallerani, who was a mistress of Ludovico Sforza, Duke of Milano. But she was not well enough born to marry him. They had a child, and he took care about both of them, mother and the child. But Duke married someone from his class, Beatrice d'Este. But when she found that he was still meeting Cecilia, she forced him to finish that relationship by marrying Cecilia to local Count Bergamino. And maybe explanation for that story is the animal on the portrait. First, when you look at the animal, it's too big. Also, the hand of a lady is bigger than her body. Leonardo was repainting twice the animal to make it bigger and more symbolic. And the Greek name of that animal is Galle. Cecilia Gallerani. Does it sound similar? Galle Gallerani. It is also a symbol of purity and moderation. As the old legend says, Ermine would face the death rather than soil its white fur while escaping. And it also became a symbol of Ludovico Sforza. He used that animal on his emblem, and he was also called Ermino because he was a member of an order of an ermine. Looking at their eyes, you can see that both Cecilia and Ermine are looking somewhere out of the portrait in the same place. Maybe it's a symbol of Ludovico together with his mistress, because they couldn't be painted on one portrait. But we also know that Cecilia was in pregnancy. And Ermine was a symbolic animal, sometimes kept in a cage in the next room as a good wish for a lady and a child. And then maybe we can say that the ermine is covering her pregnancy belly. Lady with an Ermine was painted typically for the Renaissance time. She's 16 years old on the portrait because it was not allowed to paint a girl younger than 16. She's in a typical
dress for that time, I would say very fashionable, but today not many people would dress like that because celebrities don't do it. Also, her hairstyle, cloisonné, typical for the period, with a long plait on the back and woven borders of a transparent material, keeping it all together. She's in a contrapose, what means her body is turning to the right and face left towards the light. The portrait was painted on a walnut wood panel. It's 54 centimeters high, 40 centimeters wide, and only 4 to 5 millimeters thick. It's very delicate, and because of that, it was crushed in a corner. We don't know the history of that portrait from the time when Cecilia died until the end of 1700s, when Prince Adam Jerzy Czartoryski bought it in Italy for his mother collection, Isabella. They didn't know who is on the portrait. Here in the left corner you can find La Belle Ferroniere Leonardo da Vinci. La Belle Ferroniere is a mistake. It's not her portrait. We know that it's Cecilia Gallerani, and Leonardo da Vinci is misspelled because it's written by the W, when in Polish W is pronounced as V, so we know that it was added by Isabella in Poland. Also, the background from examination, we know that it was blue and gray, but nowadays it's dark black. When exactly it was painted, it's hard to say, but it wasn't very professional work. Now it's left like that because it also presents the history of the portrait. From 1800s it became a part of Czartoryski collection and it shared the history with other exhibits. To protect it from Russian confiscation after the uprising, it was all sent to Czartoryski's place in exile in Paris, Hotel Lambert. But then, in 1870s, when Poland was still under partitions and Kraków under Austrian partition was the most liberal, they brought it to here, to Polish land. Before the World War I, to protect it, it was sent to Dresden. After the war it came back another time to Kraków. The World War II was a terrible time for Polish art. A lot was looted, and also the Czartoryski collection with Leonardo, Rembrandt and Rafael. And the last one we are still missing. Leonardo was traveling from Germany to Kraków, back to Germany, and another time here to Kraków, because Hans Frank, who was the general governor, having seat in Kraków, wanted to have it in his collection. In 1946, a lot of art came back to Poland. Also the collection with Leonardo, Rembrandt, but unfortunately without Rafael. So if you will find anywhere a painting like this, please call the museum, because we are still looking for that. But in 1946, as it was the communist country, as most of private goods, it was also nationalized. In 1989, Czartoryski Foundation was created and they got back a whole collection, and it was still in this building, in that museum. But in 2018, the whole collection was bought by Polish government. Then I can say I'm also owning Leonardo da Vinci. They pay for it 100 million euros, and even it sounds like a huge amount of money, it's not really, because we've bought Leonardo, Rembrandt, rights for Raphael, and also all other art what is here, the library with 250,000 books, and all buildings of the museum. Lady with an Ermine by Leonardo da Vinci for many people is a main reason for visiting Poland. And in the comment section below the video, tell me what is your favorite painting, who is your favorite artist. And if you are not subscribing my channel, you will find red subscription button down here. Click it to make it gray, and see you in the next episode. Bye!